this money. He's acting like a big shot. He's treating me and other people like me.
He's the man who blew the whistle on hundreds of thousands of missing narcotics pills at a Des Moines pharmacy. KCCI first broke the story last May, and today the owner of Bowder's Pharmacy faced the state pharmacy board for the first time.
And the man who tipped off the investigators was there too. KCCI's Laura Nichols reports.
This was the scene last May. KCCI has the only video of state authorities confiscating boxes and boxes of medications and documents from Bowder Pharmacy. Today at an Iowa Board of Pharmacy hearing, we met the man who started it all.
I became a whistleblower. And that's how I looked at myself.
Kirby Small, a former drug addict, says he's the one who called the Iowa Board of Pharmacy anonymously to snitch on Mark Graziano. Small accuses Graziano of selling hydrocodone pills out the back door of his pharmacy, a pharmacy that has become an Ingersoll institution for nearly 90 years.
One routine would be to just pull right around on the back door. Mike ran into the store. And then came back out with the box.
Small says he and his friend Mike Enloe would buy a box of hydrocodone containing about 5,000 pills from Graziano routinely. He says they would take the pills home and count them so they could distribute them to other friends. And he even brought what he called a souvenir to the hearing to prove it.
That was a bottle that was left at my house after a weighing session.
Graziano listened intently as Small took the stand. At one point, he even whispered to his attorney, "Are you kidding me?" Small says he decided to tell on Graziano after a fight between them turned ugly, and Graziano cut off his supply of pills.
That kind of pissed me off, and so I decided that if these guys are going to operate at this high level and be basically getting bigger than their britches and real arrogant. I saw him change to, pretty decent people to just being arrogant, money hungry.
Small's anonymous tip spurred an audit by the Iowa Board of Pharmacy. One of the compliance officers who performed the audit testified that Bowder Pharmacy had more than 740,000 hydrocodone pills that were unaccounted for between January 2008 and March 2012. Small says when he told Graziano he was going to tell on him, Graziano threatened his life.
I got people coming from out of town that are going to take care of your ass. And he was threatening me like that.
Late today, the defense began to cross-examine Kirby Small, mainly asking him about his past criminal history in an attempt to hurt his credibility. Now, the hearing will continue tomorrow. I asked Graziano's attorney if his client will take the stand. He told me it depends how things go.
Laura, just to clarify, there are no criminal charges in this case, at least right now, right?
That's correct. No criminal charges. What we're talking about here are administrative charges. From this hearing, the Iowa Board of Pharmacy will decide if it wants to give Graziano back his license or take it away completely.
Laura Nichols, thanks a lot.